And thank you for the opportunity where I can once again deliver a word for the Lord to our family. Praise the Lord. It's such a pleasure to be worshiping with you, just giving God the glory and the praise that is so rightly his. Praise the name of the Lord. Father, this morning, we want to give you thanks. We want to give you praise. We thank you so much for what you are doing in our lives in the ministry. Father, we thank you for what you're doing in Evangelist Angela's life as we come together. This morning, I ask that you would use me as your instrument. Let not self be seen. But Father, this morning, you use me as it pleases you in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Praise God. It's a new brand day, and we are here to give God all the glory, to give him all the praise. And for a short while, I'm going to be talking to us on the subject, the cause of discipleship. And you know, we have a saying that salvation is free. But I will go a little further and say, salvation is free, but it costs someone dearly for us to have that gift. Praise the name of the Lord. Looking at Matthew 16:24, and I'm reading from King James, it said, then Jesus said unto his disciples, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. So we're going to talk about the cause of discipleship. When I look at the Amplified Version and Mark 8:34, this is what it said. Jesus called the crowd together with his disciples and said to them, if anyone wishes to follow me as my disciple, he must deny himself, set aside self-interest, and take up his cross, expressing a willingness to endure whatever may come, and follow me, believing in me, conforming to my example in living, and if need be, suffering, or perhaps dying because of me. The cost of discipleship can be high because it can also, or it may also, cause us our life. And the cost of discipleship calls for a couple of things. First, it calls for self-denial. Jesus put it right up front. To be my disciples, you must deny yourself. So what is self-denial? It means while we can have the desire of our hearts, the things that we desire to have, those things in our hearts that we want or that we need, we have to deny our own way of getting them or our own way of achieving them and trust God to do it his way. Because sometimes there are things that we need and we may seek to get them one way or another, but those ways may not be the right way. Those ways may cause us to compromise. And we cannot compromise the gospel. We cannot compromise with our salvation. So we have to deny our own actions, what we would do, the way that we would take. And we have to rely on God to do it His way. Denying ourselves also means turn away from the old way of self and continually putting the new life of Christ on. We have to deny our old self and put on the new man, which is Christ Jesus. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things has become new. So when we deny ourselves, we're going to put on the old man. We're going to put on the new man. We are now in Christ, and all things become new. And when we become new, we have to deny the old way. To be a disciple of Jesus Christ, we must receive Him as Lord and depart from our old way of living and walking in the newness of life, which is lived in Christ. It's no longer us that live, but Christ that lives through us. The life we live is in Christ. Therefore, it calls for self-denial. There are a number of things we would like to do, but we can't do them. The flesh would tell us, say something. And we know within ourselves it's not right. So we can't say it. There may be some places we want to go, but because we are in Christ, we can't go those places. We have to deny ourselves of the worldly pleasures and wholeheartedly follow Christ. There's a song that said that the old way, the things we used to do, I can't do them no more. The place I used to go, I can't do them no more. It has been a great change since I was born. So it all calls for self-denial. Proverbs 14:12 say, there's a way which seems right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death. Our own way of following our own way will lead to death. But when we deny ourselves and follow the way of Christ, it leads to life eternal. To be a disciple of Jesus, we have to do things His way. The way of Christ leads to eternal life. For He is the way, the truth, and the life. Doing it our way will lead to death. And this death can be physical, or it can be spiritual, or it will be both. The way may seem right to us. It may look easy, but the end is dangerous. Theologian Bonhoeffer, in his writing, made the difference between cheap and costly grace. He stated, cheap grace is the preaching of forgiveness without requiring repentance. And you know, if we're going to forgive, there must be repentance involved. Baptism without church discipline, and communion without confession of sin. Cheap grace is grace without discipleship. Grace was given to us by Christ to become His disciples. To be his disciples, we must deny ourselves, which is the cost of discipleship. So the cost of discipleship this morning is to deny ourselves. Jesus and his teaching, or Jesus and teaching his disciples, made it plain that being a disciple of him comes with a price. It is not cheap grace. Jesus make it plain to us that to be his disciple, there is a price. The word said, we must deny ourselves, take up our cross, and follow him. The cost of discipleship is to deny ourselves. I'll say that again. The cost of discipleship is to deny ourselves. But how can we deny ourselves? Our common thoughts of self-denial is to deny ourselves of some pleasure, of good food, maybe of a good laugh. But this self-denial goes deeper than that. We are to deny our whole selves, all nature motives, or all natural motives and impulse. We must deny ourselves of all natural motives and impulse. And these are the things that we are faced with daily. We do so by doing things God's way. And sometimes doing things God's way may look foolish. Yes, the things of God will look foolish to man. Let's take a look at Noah. God told Noah to build an ark or to build a boat, because the sin of the people came up to his nostrils and he couldn't take it any longer. He said he would destroy the world with a flood. He told Noah to build an ark. This is a big boat. And Noah began to build this boat on land. Noah followed God's instruction in building the boat. And to the people of his day, it seemed foolish, because here is a man building a boat. There is no water and there is no rain inside. But Noah continued until the boat was finished. When the boat was finished, God told Noah to go into the boat with his family and take two of everything. When he entered the ark, God shut the door and he sent down the rain. To the men of Noah's day, building a boat on dry land looked foolish, but it wasn't foolish. So we, in doing things God's way, at times, it's going to look foolish, like it made no sense. God may tell us to do something that looks silly to our friends and family. But you know what? We have to deny them. We have to push back on them and do things God's way. By denying ourselves, we will put others first. We have to put God's business first. When we put God's business first, he will take care of ours. Romans 12:10 said, be kindly affectionate one to another, with brotherly love, preferring one another. We have to be kind. We have to be affectionate to others, to our brothers and sisters, to those that are in Christ, or even, or more so, to those that are unsaved, because we have to show them the way. Romans 12 and 10 says, be kindly, affectionate, one to another with brotherly love, preferring one another. We have to love others before ourselves or more than ourselves. Philippians 2:3 said, let nothing be done through strife or vainglory, but in loneliness of mind, let each esteem others better than himself. So we have to esteem others. We have to motivate others. We have to elevate others higher than we would put ourselves. It calls for self-denial for us to do this. Because there are many times we don't want no person, or we don't want to think of any person higher than we think of ourselves. But the Bible tells us this is what we should do. That is self-denial, putting others first. It's a hard thing to do, but if we want to be Christ's disciples, we have to do it. The cost of discipleship is being actively taking up our cross and following Jesus. Jesus said we must take up our cross and follow him. Jesus' cross was a wooden cross, but our cross comes in the forms of testing and trials and persecution, which can also lead to death. One writer asked the question, must Jesus bear the cross alone and all the world go free? He said, no, there is a cross for everyone, and there is a cross for me. There is a cross for me, and there is a cross for you. My cross will be different, or may be different to your cross. Nonetheless, we must carry our cross. And there are three things Jesus mentioned, or 3 points Jesus mentioned, which belong to the character of a true believer or a true disciple. Watch it. The first is self-denial. He said, let him deny himself. One, self-denial. If a man follow Jesus, it must be by his own free will. Jesus will not force no one to follow him. He has given us that choice. It's our free will, and we have to deny ourselves. Two, the second point, take up his cross. That man or that person must be eager to endure shame, suffering, and even death if it happens. We cannot escape it. The third point Jesus made is follow me. That man, that woman, that boy or girl must be energetic and active. He cannot be passive. When we are following Christ, when we are his disciples, we cannot be passive. We have to be actively involved. We must follow Jesus' footsteps with zeal, even unto death. Christ has gone the way before us, and in his strength, we can do it. His footprints are there. His footsteps are there. So we can follow. The disciples pay for their discipleship. You may ask me, how did the disciples pay for their discipleship? Well, let me give you a couple of examples. They were persecuted. Their lives were threatened. They had to go from city to city. Some of them were beaten. So let's take a look at Peter. The cost of his discipleship was being beaten, being charged, being put in prison, and in the end, it cost him his life. Peter was put to death by crucifixion. And when he was being crucified, he thought of himself not worthy. He denied himself of being crucified with his head up because his Savior, his Master, was crucified head up. And he thought it, I am not worthy. I would deny myself even in death. And he asked them to crucify him with his head down. Next example, John. He was in prison. He was warned. He went from city to city to avoid persecution. In the end, because he denied himself and preached the gospel, he was placed in oil, boiling oil. And when he refused to die, he was taken out and banished on an island by himself called the Isles of Patmos, the place where God gave him the revelation of the end time. And he wrote the book of Revelation. Last, Paul. He was the last one to become the disciple of Jesus Christ. He said, I was born out of season, and I'm the least to be called an apostle. But he was called to preach to the Gentiles. Paul was beaten. He was cast out of the city and left to die. He was shipwrecked. He was thrown in prison, all for the gospel of Jesus Christ. All for the gospel's sake. But in the end, he was placed in prison and he was later beheaded. There's a cost for discipleship. How much are we willing to pay? How much are we willing to sacrifice for the gospel of Jesus Christ? All that are godly will suffer persecution. And think it not strange when fiery troubles come to test us. Salvation is absolutely free. But once you receive it, it will cost you everything because you have to deny yourself, take up your cross, and follow Jesus Christ. To truly follow Christ, we must surrender to him as he guides us through the process. We cannot do it without him. Therefore, let us give up our own desires, our own thoughts, our own selfish ways, and let us submit to the will, the plan, and purpose God has for us. Let us take up our cross and follow Jesus Christ and spread the gospel in this end time. If any man would come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. And we can do this by denying ourselves. The cost of discipleship is self-denial. God bless you. Father, I thank you this morning for your word. Help us as believers, as disciples of Jesus Christ, to truly deny ourselves, take up our crosses, and follow you in Jesus' name. Amen.